Hello, I'm Beth Ebersole from SAS. I'm going to talk to you about how you can use SAS to very quickly simulate and graph data from different distributions. Why are distributions important? Well, many models have assumptions about the distribution of the data or the errors. For example, ordinary least squares linear regression assumes normality. It assumes that the error term follows a normal distribution with mean zero. It also assumes that the errors are identically distributed and independent. And it assumes equal variance or homoscedasticity. Finally, of course, any linear model assumes linearity, and that's in the parameters, linearity in the parameters. Now, other models, such as the generalized additive model, can accommodate many different distributions, such as normal Poisson, negative binomial, and gamma, and other distributions. So let's talk about some of these common distributions. I'm going to cover normal, which is the same as Gaussian, negative binomial, Poisson, and gamma. In this video, I'll show you how to create PDFs, probability density functions, from these different distributions and how to simulate data. For the normal or Gaussian distribution, there are two parameters. There's the mean, commonly mu is used to designate the mean, and there's the standard deviation or variance, and commonly sigma is used. But remember, different people use different Greek or Latin letters to mean the same thing. For many regression models, the errors must be normally distributed. Binomial and negative binomial distributions are used for sequential independent Bernoulli trials. Think of flipping a coin, where your likelihood of success, or P, is in a fair coin is going to be 0.5, or half the time you'll get heads, half the time you'll get tails. If you flip the coin 10 times, how many times are you going to get heads, or you might consider heads your success? How many times are you going to get tails? So the negative binomial distribution models the number of failures before K successes occur. The Poisson distribution is commonly used for count data, things like how many fish a waterman catches in a day, or the number of births per year in a city, or maybe the number of Barbie dolls sold each day in a store. There is only a single parameter for the Poisson distribution, commonly called lambda. If I adjust lambda, you can see as I change it from 2 to 4 to 16, which you'll easily see you can do with SAS code in SAS Studio, you can see how that changes the distribution. The gamma distribution is commonly used for time between independent events. There are two parameters required, a shape parameter and a scale or rate parameter. So let me show you how to create these PDFs and also to simulate data. Here I am in SAS Studio. First, I'm going to create PDFs. I've already created a snippet with the code, so you don't have to sit here and watch me type. So let's look first for the normal or Gaussian PDF. I'm going to just name this, give this a name, the data set in our data step. I'm just calling it normal PDF. Then I'm going to have a do loop where I go x from minus 3 to 3 by 0.1. And here is my PDF function. I'm going to set y equals to PDF normal. I'm going to let the parameters for the mean and the standard deviation be just the defaults. I'll output the data, and then I end my do loop and run this. Then I just have a simple proc sg plot here. I call the data above, I give it a title, I'm going to set my series x equals x, y equals y. I'm going to give it some information about how I want this to display. And then I'll run this. And see, you have a normal probability density function. Likewise, I can do this with the Poisson PDF. Here, I'm going to set a macro. I'm going to be able to change this if I want to. So I'm going to percent let lambda equal 2. Then I'm going to create a data set that I'm going to call Poisson PDF. I'm going to do k equals 0 to 10. Here is my PDF function. I'm going to call for Poisson, and I'm going to call for k, and I'm going to change my percent lambda. I can change that by changing this percent let statement up here. Output, end, and run just as before, and we have a simple sgplot. Let's run this. And here's my Poisson probability density function for lambda equals 2. What if I want to change that to 3? Run it again. And now I see a slightly different probability density function. Let's look at negative binomial. Here, I'm going to set up two macro variables with percent let m equal 3, percent let p equals 0.5. So remember, our p means likelihood of success. So this is going to be 50-50. 50% success likelihood, 50% failure likelihood. I have my data set, which I'm going to call neg binomial PDF. I'm going to do k equals 1 to 50. Here's my PDF function where I call for the negative binomial. I have my ampersand m, which is going to resolve to 3, and my ampersand p, which is going to resolve to 0.5, and my k. I run that, and I create a plot. And here's my negative binomial probability density function with m equal 3, p equal 0.5. Let me change my p equal to 0.8. So now we're not talking about a fair coin. We're talking about something where it's 80% likelihood of success. And you see I get a different probability distribution function. Now for my gamma PDF, I'm going to again set two macro variables, A and lambda. I'm going to create a data set gamma PDF. I'm going to create a do loop where x equals 0 to 15 by 0.01. And here my y equals PDF gamma x, and it will resolve here to 3. And the lambda will resolve to 1. I'll plot this. And you see I have a very nice graph here of my probability distribution function. So that was just creating PDFs, but what if we want to simulate data from these different distributions? Let me open up another program here I've saved in my snippets here in SAS Studio, very conveniently. And first, I'm going to simulate data from a normal or Gaussian distribution. I'm going to show you I can set a random seed. I'm only going to do that in the first one. It's something that you can do if it's important to you. You can set the seed to whatever you want. Or here, I'm setting by call stream init 0. I'm generating the seed from a system clock. I can do I equals 1 to 100,000. Well, now my function is rand. Rand normal, I'm going to go with the default mean of 0. Output, end, and run. I can print some of my data to make sure everything worked properly. And I can do a proc univariate to get my histogram. So I can see from my proc univariate, I created data with 100,000 observations. The mean is approximately 0. That was the default. I didn't set that. The variance is approximately 1. Also the default. I didn't set that. Variance is the same as our standard deviation. And you see our skewness and kurtosis are both near 0. And this is what the data look like when plotted, you know, in a histogram. So that was very easy way to just super quickly create a data set that's normally distributed. I can do the same for binomial. Again, I have a couple of macro variables here. I'm going to use my RAND with negative binomial and my P and K. I'm going to run this with my proc univariate. And I get the negative binomial distributed data. Here, maybe I want to try a Poisson data set. So I'm going to let lambda equal 2. I'm going to do I equals 1 to 100,000. I'll do RAND, my RAND function with Poisson and lambda, and I'll run this one. So here's my data with lambda equals 2. What if I want to change lambda to 6? I can just change my percent let statement, rerun this. And now I have a data set with, as we can see up here, I have 100,000 variables. My mean is 6. And I have my standard deviation and variance. And notice these are not the same in the Poisson distribution. And I have my graph of the histogram of the data. And finally, let me create some data from the gamma distribution. I'm going to let A equal 2, lambda equal 2, and again, create 100,000 observations and use the RAND function with gamma. And so that was the gamma function. You can see the histogram here. It was just that easy. Very simple. In addition to these examples I've shown you, you can see other examples in the SAS documentation. There are a number of examples for all kinds of distributions there.